Hello. Today we're going to be looking at how to store values and evaluate expressions from those stored values using the scientific calculator, the fx300ESPlus2. The steps would be the same for any Casio scientific calculator, but I'm using this model right now. So basically, we're using the store functionality. So that's this right here. You'll notice it's in yellow above the recall, which means we have to hit our shift and then that. So I'm using two activities to kind of exemplify when you might want to do this type of thing. So this first activity is basically about writing equivalent expressions. So students are given some dimensions and they're asked to simplify and write different expressions that have the same value. So you might want to store a specific number for x, whatever it might be, since we're using x in these cases, and show that this long expression for finding perimeter is equal to the simplified version. So for example, let's first store our x value. So to do that, decide what you want your value to be. So let's say we want our value to be 4. I'm sorry, 5. So you choose your value and then you tell the calculator that you want to shift, recall, store. So you'll notice that store shows up here in the window. And now you decide which variable you're going to use. Well, we're using x in this case. So we're going to hit, notice the x is right here where the close parentheses is. So we're going to hit that. And this shows you that we are storing, that's what the little arrow means, for x this value of 5. So anytime I use x, I am going to be using the value of 5 until I maybe change it again. So for example, we can just test it out. If I type in 2x, and this time I do have to use my alpha key to get that x because it's red, and hit enter, notice it has a value of 10 because x is stored as a 5. So in this activity, the idea is you've stored a value for x and then you're writing different expressions that should have the same value. So you have this expression here, which is, you know, the perimeter x plus 2x plus 3 plus another x plus 2x plus 3. So you're supposed to show that you can simplify that, make that easier. So let's just type in the really long one the way it is now. So x plus 2x. And so notice every time I need to use the x, I'm using the red alpha key so that it shows up as an x. Make sure I'm doing this. 3 plus x plus 2x. Plus 3. And hit equal. And has a value of 36. Because remember, every time x is used, it's as a 5. But what we're asking students to do is, can you write this in a simpler form? Combine like terms is really where we're going. So if I've got x, that's 3x, 4x, 6x. So this should be the same as 6x. Plus, and it looks like I have a 3 and a 3, 6. So I hopefully am going to get also 36. Let's see. And we do. So that's where they're going. They've got this stored value. They don't have to worry about what it is. They could change the value to anything else, but that's how you store a value for a specific variable. The next activity I want to look at is also using stored values. I just want to show you that. But I don't have to use X. I can really use any alphabet if I want. So in this case, you'll see this is sort of a game and they're trying to learn about base and exponent. So when I do this, I'm going to store different values. So I have A is 1, B is 2, C is 3, D is 4, E is 5. So I have 5 different variables and I'm going to give each one of them a different stored value. So to do that, again, I'm going to hit the value first. So 1, hit my shift, store, and then my A. So my A is here. And I have stored the 1 for A. And now let's do another one. For B, we're going to hit 2, shift, store, and then our B. And now for C, 3. So very easy really to do this. I've stored them. So the value first, then shift, recall to hit the store up, and then the variable that you want to use. In this case, it's D. So let's just put that last one in there. And E. All right, so now that I have all of those stored in here and I'm working on this activity, I don't have to think about it. I can set up different ways. And this activity in particular is challenging students. Can you create an expression, an exponential expression, who's with a power whose value is greater than 6 but less than 10. So we can do, let's see, I'm going to just use their example up here. So I'm going to do C. And remember what C is. C has a value of 3. And then I'm going to use my exponent and raise it to the value of, what do they have? They have B. So because it's using stored values, it's doing 3 to the second power, which we know is 9. And there's our solution. So storing values that you're going to use over and over again is a really nice feature. And that's a very simple process in doing that.